Okay, so, yeah. Again, good morning, good evening. Welcome to the session number 7 of post-processing webinar in 2019. Today I have two topics on the list. The one is workflow for the UDE editor, how to deal with them, how to add a new UDE, and I will do this on a use case from a customer from last week. So I think it's a real use case, and maybe you can also reuse it later on. And in the second part, I want to talk about the pretreatment and how it works, what you can do with that, the two simple commands, how to use it, and yeah. And if we have time, or if there are additional questions, we can have a Q&A or additional discussion on single topics. Okay, so let's start with UDE editor based on a use case. Use case more or less very simple. Some of you may be aware of it. In Synumeric controller, we have a cycle 832 for high-speed settings, and especially some of machine manufacturers like DMG, they have their own high-speed cycle settings. In this case, DM80C, and expect 6 parameters for the A, B, C, D, E, F, like for speed surface accuray, what is ray class, tolerances, and kind of surface. So the request here was, or the use case in this context is, okay, instead of the cycle 832 output, I want to output the DM80C cycle. And but this should only happen if it's first set by an UDE. And if it's not set by this additional UDE, then the standard cycle 832 output should be used. So this is the request. In general, one thing to UDEs, I mean, I think everyone is aware of it. In general, in Post Configurator, before implementing something, you should think about, is it really make it sense to add a new UDE, or is it maybe some more galactic, or you can use every time in the post processor, and you have to implement it maybe as a property in the post processor itself. In this context here, it make definitely sense to have this as an additional UDE, because the CAM programmer at the end want to control it, and the CAM programmer don't want to change the post processor. He want directly to do it in the operation, attach the UDE or not, and based on this, we will implement this now. Okay, so I will do that based on the SimuAct from the current latest, or more or less latest release of NX 8072 series, and based on the post processor behind it. So in general, let me first open the one. So in general, for UDEs, we have to do multiple steps. First is basic definition of the UDE. For this, we have in Post Configurator, we have an integrated user-defined events editor. So can just start it. This message just indicates, okay, there is no customer CDA file, means there's currently in this post processor, there's no custom modifications made, and it will create a new one and will include it in the post processor. So say yes. And now the UDE editor is open here. In general, I get all the events which are available currently with this post processor. Most of them are all of them here are the standard ones we deliver out of the box. And to create a new one, I have two options. So the first option is directly say, okay, I want to add a new event. We'll create an empty event, or if I want to reuse something similar, like the coolant, for example, I can also say, okay, I want to duplicate this event, and then I don't have to redefine all the things again and again. In this case, because it's completely new, I will start with an empty event. So click add new event. And the name, what I see here, it's at the end the user will see in the UI when add an UDE to an operation. So let us name this DM ATC. Second one, event ID. This is the event handler, which is used in TCL to execute the commands. To keep it simple, let me also name it DM, but I use the underscore because in MOM events it's not allowed to have a white space. Yeah, TCL. Post event you can normally leave empty. This is only useful. I mean, it's more, I think, for legacy reason, but at the end you can say when you specify a different post event, then it will execute this one. So if I create a completely different name, I can put it in here, and it will not execute the MOM DM ATC event. It will create like a custom procedure, whatever. So normally, my recommendation, don't use this post event because it makes the things more confusing. But maybe there's a use case where you need it, but in general, I would say no, not use it. So description is when you want to add some additional things like yeah, bitmap, link to yeah, for example to Google, whatever. Category I think is also clear, it's from the past. More or less that means in which category this UDE should be available. If I use the specify option here, I can check for example milling and drilling. That means if I attach an UDE to a milling or drilling operation, this UDE will be available. If I have a turning operation and this is not checked, this UDE will not be available. Or if you say, okay, it should be available for all categories, then just keeps all. So this is the first, the main definition. And now we have to define the single items. At the end, there's one existing item which is automatically generated. And now let's switch back here to documentation. So what we need first the ape parameter with four things: standard, speed, surface, accuracy. Means as a type we need enum, enumeration. And let us name this one. One thing here. This is the MOM variable we use later in TCL. It's not a good idea, for example, to do like this here. Because what happens, all those names here get an upper lowercase MOM underscore before. That means in this context means I create a variable named MOM tool name, but also from NX Core we have a variable MOM tool name, and this can yeah, corrupt your post output. Recommendation here is all the time start with an yeah, unique identifier that you don't run into this issue. In this case, let me say I name it DMU and then surface type. And in the UI, I just say that is what the user will see in the UI. So surface type. And I have four operations. The first one standard, the second one speed, third one surface, and the last one accuracy. So click the apply button. And so default value is standard. That's the first one. The second one, let me go back to the slide, is parameter B. That's the vague class. So let me add a new item. It will make a copy of the last item in this here it makes sense definitely. So means I rename the variable. In this case it's named a vague class. Label is vague class. And I have, I remember correctly, three values like light, medium, heavy. So means light, medium, heavy. Okay, and Lickabalai. And say, let's say the default value is medium. And apply. So then from documentation we have the tolerances for the linear axis, rotary axis and for component. All those three parameters we can directly get out of NXCam. So this should not be a setting the user have to set up. It should be automatically generated by the operation. That means the last parameter we need in the UDE to enter is the advanced surface, top surface or the off option, which is currently not here on the document. So again, use the last one, add the item, rename it to, let's name it ATC Machining. ATC Machining. And from the enumeration, we have the advanced surface option. We have the top surface option. And last but not least, we have the off option. So, by the way, this is fixed in the newer version. So that is all the time why I press first the apply button. And then just go to the default value and change it, by the way. Okay, and let's say this ATC machining have the advanced surface as standard value. Okay, so that first the definition of the UI. Now this internal integrated editor have two big advantages. The first one is I can directly preview the dialog, so how it looks later on for the user. So if I now press a button, I get the view of the later used when I attach it to an operation. So in this case, it's standard, medium, and advanced top surface off. Okay. The second good thing we have implement here is so in the past, now you go to your TCL, you create the procedure, or it's already created the procedure body, and you add now all the MOM events. What you can do in within the application here, just click on this list event information window, and you directly get an overview about the used variables. I think this is the internal error from the morning here, but we will see in a second. And you directly get the procedure body with all the variables. So this is what we need in our TCL. So let us copy that and close the UDE editor. Open our service file. Oh, it's on the other screen. And now first our MOM command here. So, and just for testing, before we starting any further actions, let us say, okay, we make a MOM output, MOM output literally here, and just let's say it's cycle, not cycle, oh God, DMATC, escape. This is the parameter A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. So without setting any variables, it's just outputting this hard-coded string first. So now click OK. The first thing we have to do, we have now attached this UDE to the operation. Because maybe you're aware of that, when you add a new UDE, it was also the case before with other post applications. And you are in the session, you have to reload the preferences. Sometimes this works good, sometimes not. So what I normally do, sorry, it was too fast, menu preferences, manufacturing, and then reset the configuration file and the template set. That means the CDL file and the dev file of the post processor will pass again and reload completely. So let me do that. Click OK. And hopefully, when I now say right mouse button, object start events, it should be shown up here in the list. So, and there's my DM ATC. So let me add the event here with the standard medium advanced surface. That's fine. Okay. And now let's have a first post-process run. That's the SMOM output little bit is outputted because then I'm sure it's going through the procedure. In this case, a little bit here. So this is our output here: DM, ATC, A, B, C, D, E, F, and it's currently outputted before the cycle H32. So that means this is working. UDE is created. It's attached to an operation. Now we can go into detail what we have to do in the UDE from TCL side. So the first thing is we have the variables and we have to set values at the end. In this case, let me start with the switch surface type. This one, and what I want is it's yeah. Standard. Now one hint here. In the definition of the UDE, I wrote it in with a starting uppercase and then lowercase. Internally in NX Core, all strings are converted automatically to uppercase. This is one of the most issues can happens to people, and they're asking why it doesn't run into this because it's internally converted to uppercase. That means if I work with strings in the UDE, think all the time about standard or use TCL methods like yeah, to convert it all to uppercase and then compare the string. So in this case, I directly do the uppercase and I say is it standard? We set A to 0. That's the first one. Now just copy this, and we need three further conditions. So the next one is the speed. Next one after that is the surface, and finally we have accuracy. Accuracy. And in case of speed, A is 1, in case of surface it's 2, and in case of accuracy it's 3. So that's the first one. Then we have two other options. So to make it much easier, I copy me now the block, the bit formatting, and now we have the wake class. Means one, and the wake class it's liked medium and and this is the third one we don't need, and this is our parameter B. So one comment because this was a question in the morning. I think some of you are aware of that. In this case, I just use the double point. That means I declare this variable b, as a global variable. Okay. I mean, maybe b is not the best name for a global variable, but that can be every name. Just want to mention this is a global definition. The other way is to just write global and then a, b, and so on. Okay, so then we copy this block again, and we have the last option, that is the kind of machining. And then we have the groundwork done. So MOM DMU ATC machining. Replace this one, and we have the options of advanced. One. The second one is top surface, and the last one if the option is switched to off. And this is our C-Parameter. So. Means first, let's do it simple here. Directly here, let us say, okay, this is Dollar A, this is now Dollar B, and I mean, this is not matching here this C, because this is a linear tolerance, rotary tolerance, component tolerance, and this is the C. So, Frank, there was, I see you've written a question about the global. Let me maybe explain again. The A, B, and C don't need a global because I used directly those two double points. That means it's defined in a global namespace directly. And that means I don't need the global definition. So it's very similar if I'm writing like, let me do it with D. So if I write this, it's now a global D variable. If I just say this and a value, it's also a global variable set with a value D. At the end,
I guess my real question is, do they really need to be global, or can they just be local to zero?
I all the time use only if possible the double point. It's
But since you're using them in the same proc, can it just be ABC without?
right. I mean, if you only have a local variable, then you don't need the global one, right? So, I know. Yes, sure. You can also have a local variable A
Okay.
only. Yep, right. Okay. So means let's have a short test that this is working here. Maybe I did some TCL error. I hope not, but we will see in a second. And that's very similar to the morning. So let me double check. Can't we see no such variable? Okay. So this is something I also met in the morning. The machining. So let me do one thing before I run into the same issues. Let me restart my X that the UDE is correctly passed. Takes 30 seconds. I mean, from experience and also when from discussions from other guys or other post developers, lots of them after they add a new UDE or something, they completely restart in X because this avoid those yeah failures at the end. So again, let me add this UDE standard medium advanced surface. Okay. Let's put this again. And very similar to the morning. So let me. I mean, at the end, this is saying there is no variable set. That means maybe it not runs into this one here. So let me do an default at the end. And let me set. Just to check that this is working, and then I have.
You need a space in there.
Is a space? Ah, shit.
No, you didn't put a space in there.
Ah. Thank you, Frank. Okay. So. First, this is working, and for the last one, we have to double check later on. But I think this is somewhere the value is not set correctly, so we have to take care of the current value. Nevertheless, that so the next step is Currently, it's outputted with this DM ATC and the cycle 832 is output, right? So, and in the. But we need. Okay, let me check why. Advanced surface. Let me double check the UDE definition shortly. Maybe there's an issue. So we have advanced surface, top surface off. That's fine. Go into the UDE. Select the top surface. So top surface is defined as 1. Let's have a post process again. Okay, so there's some issue with this advance. I have to double check. Maybe I advanced. Maybe I have some.
Go back in at the service level. Did you put it? Was it advanced or advanced? You have it spelled right. Okay.
Good point. Maybe double check again. DMC. Okay. I mean, doesn't matter. Let's go further with the top surface here. Okay. I have to double check at the end why it's not advanced surface, but we will find out on a later point. Okay. So the more important point is now I have to. If it's top surface, I don't want to output the cycle 833, right? So to find out the correct place, let us switch on the inspect tool, post-process this operation, and at the end, go to the NC output, open the face top, and the cycle 832. That means if this is set to top surface, I don't want to output this line anymore. When you select the line, just switch to the buffer events now, and we get the buffer to modify it. And what you can do during the runtime of a post-processor, you can dynamically change buffers. So let me copy this to clipboard to show shortly. And to keep in the sample means if it's a top surface. So the first one is I set C to 1. But additional to that, I want to modify this buffer. At the end, there's one command which is very important to do it dynamically during the runtime. That is named libge command buffer sequence. This is one of the first buffer commands we have. At the end, I can use this one here. And now I can at the end call here now a procedure what should be executed. In the case of the top surface, I don't want I change this buffer that it will execute my own procedure. And at the end, this is my DM ATC. So let me create a new procedure with the name DM ATC. And in this one, we just output this line. And this is what we not need. And in the other case, for example, if it's set to off, we want restore the buffer. And restore means that we use the standard output. In this case, I mean, you now have to trust me. it's cycle 832. This is the tag you get out of the inspect tool. At the end, you see it here. This is this cycle 832 tag. Means in the case of the UDE is set to off, it will restore it. In the case of top surface, and not for sure, I mean, this is currently not working. We have to check, double check. But also in the case of advanced surface, we want to execute our DM ATC. Okay? So, now click OK. And let's check what happens. So, if I post process this one operation now, we now have only the DM ATC and no Cycle832 output anymore. Okay. So now there is the next challenge. Currently, this UDE is only attached to the phase stop operation, right? That means if I now post process the program group here, I would expect, ideally, phase top is attached, it outputs my DM ADC, and the other ones, cavity top, cavity mill, will still contain the Cycle832 output. But unfortunately, that is not the case, because we changed the buffer and we did not bring it back at the end. So that means that this is the first operation, and in the second operation, we still get our DM ATC because the variable is still there. It still has the value. Means what we have to do, we have to unset the variable of the UDE at the end of pass. Means we go again, phase top, maybe from the mom events view, phase top, mom end of pass, go to the buffer events, and search for a good buffer we can use. In this case, there's a buffer named unset variables. Sounds good. Sounds like this buffer will be used for those things. And let's say we append something, copy to clipboard, and go to the service file again. And put it here. So now we need an additional procedure. This procedure, let's name that unset ATC. This procedure we calling instead of this code here. And the tag is this unique identifier. Let's name it similar unset DM ATC. So what we now have to do, the only thing is, at the end we asking this mom DMU ATC machining, right? That means at the end, if we unset this variable, in the next operation it will not be available, and means we will never run into this switch command, or we run into this C3, but we will not change the buffer. So what we now doing, okay, let's say, we're asking here for if info exists. Now let me not repeat my issue in the morning. Global mom DMU ATC machining. And if this one is exists, we want to simple unset the variable. And for sure, the more important point, we want to restore the buffer. At the end, it's similar to what we did here in the off. That means I just copy this line now, go to here, paste it, and save it. So let's have a post-process run. Going to the top here. So the first one, the UDE is still attached. That's fine. Now we have the second operation, and now I get my Cycle832 output again. And for the final testing, that everything is working, let us attach this to the last operation also. And maybe let's say it's surface, it's liked, and let's keep advanced surface. So, and now post process again to be sure all the cases are working. So first operation, we have our DM ATC, that's great. Second operation, we have a Cycle832, that's also great. And third operation, we have a Cycle832, what is not great, but I think this is belongs this advanced surface, right? Because I set it again to advanced. Where is the issue here? I don't see it. Advanced surface. Top surface. So, first, that's also fine. And here, okay, so somewhere I have the issue with this advanced. There's something in the wording wrong. Whatever. Okay. This is in general how to set up the UDE. What is still now missing here? This is one thing. This is the chem tolerance, right? So, and as I mentioned before, we have here the CDE from the documentation. It's the tolerance for linear access, rotary access, and for component. At the end, in Cinemaric, we have the standard variable, what you can do, like chem tolerance, which we also output in the header. And let's calculate the value by the cycle itself at the end. So this is means divide by two. For rotary, normally, I mean, this really depends on the machining and how you want to set up your chem tolerances, so your intol and outol. For rotary, you have a good standard default of 5. And for the component, let's say chem tolerance divided by 2. And that's it. For sure, I think I mentioned it also before in other sessions. Currently, this is MOM output little hard coded. The more better way, but because of the limitation of the time, it should be a block template. So at the end, this should be called by a block template, not with an hard coded MOM output little, because then you not know, or the post processor not knowing the status of it. But in the context of this, it's fine to do that, but I recommend in general use block templates. So means our final output now should look like close perfect. So means this is the output, the chem tolerance is coming from the operation. We output automatically with the system, calling the DMATC cycle with the setup parameters from the UDE, and calculates the chem tolerance directly inside of the cycle itself. Okay, so the John asking, yes, you can still use macros in PostConfigurator. What we not have in PostConfigurator is an editor to create macros. There are some discussions about it also in the past. At the end, also cycles and so on, you can do it by block templates. And currently we decide to just go forward with block templates, but we still support the macros. So it's not out, you can also define macros and use them. Okay, any questions to the UDE topic? Sounds like a no, then let's go over to the second topic, which also influences this topic, pretreatment. In general, I mean, it's not, we have 20 minutes, so we will not go into the last detail, but I just want to show today how it works, what we do behind the scenes here in NX Core, and a small simple implementation which you can reuse for everything. This I will be shown now within the next 20 minutes. In general, post-processing, how it works in NX, if we talk in the context of post-processing with TCL, some of you I think already know this slides, but in short, we have our chem part, the chem data storage. It contains the tool pass information, the pass events, tools, and all the things. And what we do in the background is what we named event generator, the MOM architecture at the end. You are already known with all the mom variables, the mom events. And the connection at the end is to the TCL and definition file. That means in TCL I create an event, like the UDE event we created. Internally it will create this mom event and execute the TCL definition of it. And this will be output to an output file. So this is a simple way of post-processing, very simplified here. But at the end it's the way how it works. If we talk post-processing with pretreatment, so in general, pretreatment, for what is it, if you don't aware of it, with pretreatment, you can select, not select, collect information in the beginning. For example, you want to output something in the start of program, but the information is only available in the last operation. And with a normal post-processing way, because it's like a sequence we currently post-processing, it's not possible to output the information from the last operation directly in the beginning, because you don't know it. So this is why we introduce this pretreatment functionality with PostConfigurator. And at the end, also it's very simplified here. At the end, you can just imagine it's like a double post one, more or less. That means in the pretreatment, when you start the post-processing one, we first run a pretreatment post-process one, which also contains most of all the event generated by the NX core. We have also an event handler file for the pretreatment, which executes things, but it not execute everything. And that is why the pretreatment is very fast, because we only collect necessary or really necessary information, like what is the next operation type, is it 3 plus 2 simultaneous, to, for example, output specific safety behavior of the positioning of machine tool access. In the pretreatment itself, all this information will be collected, and at the end it's not a temporary info file, it's in this memory of an NX core at the end. And when the pretreatment one is finished, we start the normal post-process with all the events and with the event handler defined in the TCL. And at this point, there's a connection to this pretreatment. That means I can get the information of the pretreatment into my, as I mentioned, in my second post-process one. And can use this information directly in this beginning from the start of program to output additional information like a tool. There are so much use cases: tool list, operation list, coordinate systems. I want to know which, if a UDE is attached to some operations or something. So this first in general to the pretreatment. The use case, let us keep it in a loop with the UDE we create before. So one of the things we deliver with pretreatment, we collect standard information, and this is already available. But there's also a possibility, for example, when you create a UDE, to extend the pretreatment with your information, to select the information and, for example, output it in the start of program. So to do that, there's one really important command. Let me minimize it a little bit here. So now, there's one important command that is named libspf-pretreatment-advar. That means if a variable is not automatically collected by the pretreatment, and for example, if you create your own UDE, you have to add this variable to the pretreatment if you want to use it. In general, there's an overview. Let me open shortly the documentation. There's an overview in the manufacturing post-configurator library commands help, and here in the lib standard post functionality. So all the functionality I show here, it's described also here. At the end, this libspf pretreatment advar, for example, and it's just telling you what you have to do. And what is this procedure doing, how to use it, and all the time you have an example here. The important point here is the first line, the purpose. There's a sentence called this procedure insights the procedure libspfpt additional variables underscore xxx. That means when I want to add variables to the pretreatment, I need a procedure with this name. Okay, so let's start with that. Go to the service file. Let's say a new proc. And this procedure should be named libspfpt additional variables. And this can be any name at the end. So, and second step is now we want to add the, for example, we want to output the UDE settings of advanced surface, top surface, off in the header, or what is the setting of the UDE. Means we need, let me go back to here. We need this command here, libspf pretreatment advar, the procedure name and the variable name, how it should be collected. You can also, for example, just use copy an example when you try it out to get the information or to, yeah, to play around a little bit with it to get a feeling for it. In this case, let me write it down, libspf. At pretreatment advar. So now it expects the mom event. The mom event is what is generated by the UDE. This is the mom event, mom DM ATC. That means I have to point the mom event where the variable is available at the end, right? Because it's like a post one, the first post one. And I want to collect the variable mom DMU. Machining, and I want to collect it. This is the third parameter. Zero means for the operation. Right. The current value of the given variable is memorized at the specified event name, means for once per operation. So this you can do with everything. It can be also existing mom commands, existing variables which are not collect. When you want to know which variables are collect, you will find this also in the help. Therefore, we have the second command. You find it under libspf get pretreatment. So those are the most used functionalities, libspf get pretreatment and the add a variable to the pretreatment. And this also includes a list of which variables are always accessible. So that means this is something we collect out of the box with our standard PostConverter implementation. There are multiple ones like mom-tool-name, mom-tool-number, but for sure not additional ones like a UDE I add. So the next step now is we want to output this in the at the end in the start of program. And for this, we need two things. First, we need a procedure. So, again, work. And this procedure is, let's name my pretreatment. And now, one, let me first write it for each E. libspf get pretreatment. And now there's one thing, I mean what we have to do when we, this is what we call in the start of program, and that means if my UDE is attached to multiple operations or which variable forever, means it's stored in an array or in a list. That means if I want to output some of the values, I have to iterate through this list. Personally, I use all the time this for each element, and now this is the point. There is a variable available which is automatically collected, this operation list. That means what I do here, I go through each element of the collected operation list, and inside of that, I just asking if again now libspf get pretreatment, And now I ask the variable I collect here, this mom DMU ATC machining. The current operation from the current element means dollar E. So for this element, I want to get the value of the current operation. And if this one is well, this way, unequal string empty. So if there's no value available, the collected value for this operation will be have an empty string, nothing more. It's like an empty string, but I only want to execute something if the string is not empty. And in this case, what I want is to, let's do it simple here, mom output text. And now we can copy this one here, the passPF. Value and just copy this line because we want to output the value of it and quotes. So what I want to say here is this here and this here you can reuse for everything because in the operation list you have access to all variables every time and inside of that just point to your specific one. Or to your specific block, whatever you want to output. That means you ideally you only define two procedures and can handle all the stuff inside of that. So the only thing we now have to do, we have to call this in the start of program, right? To do that, will be straightforward as every time. Switch on the inspect tool. And go start of program, and directly in the start of program, directly in the beginning or after the ini file creation means the first buffer. We want to execute our pretreatment functionality that it will output the values of the UDE. So again, that's the buffer, and we call the procedure inside of this buffer. My pretreatment output. And okay. So and if everything goes fine, then we have now directly in the top, we have the value top surface, top surface. For sure the advance is not working. but let's change maybe the last one here to off now. Okay. Post process again. Now we have the value off. Okay. So at the end, the message here is you can easily extend it. With two procedures, and this really depends on the use case you need, what you want to output, how you want to output, if you want to set maybe variables. For example, you can also switch solutions with that, kinematic solutions, and then just do a mom reload kinematics and so on. So there are multiple ways how you can use that. This is the basic way how to implement it. And because I think if you only take care of those two procedures, you are fine. And it's for sure the first time, especially the second one part here, this is maybe the first time a little bit hard to do. But at the end, it's all the time the same. So you do it one time and then it will work all the time. Okay. Then. Any question to the pretreatment? Or was it too much information in a short time? to less information. Maybe you want to know more. I mean, as I said, for this pretreatment, if you have a use case, yeah, just take a look in this documentation, libspf get pretreatment and libspf add pretreatment vars. And there are all information there. So you just read it one time and can reuse it very simply. And the good thing is really in this documentation, all the time you have an example. So if you just want to try it out, let me, for example, like this one, I just copy it out from here. For sure, I have to call it here and just say, okay, I want to. Sorry, to do it in the for each here and just say mom output text instead of set the variable. So it means if I now post process the cavity mill. Output because sorry, missed something. For sure. Similar to this one. So now I get the output. It's a constant operation. Okay, so then there was a question, are cycle objects passes and data stored with... Sorry, I don't get the question completely then. Can you maybe explain a little bit more? What do you mean with that? To be honest, then I am out at this point. I mean, at the end, every information is accessible, like before. So there's a same TCL behind. If there's some, I heard of momcycle objects, but never used it. But at the end. Yeah, it's similar. So you can also use this one for sure. It's still there, but what we want to try, there are more than momcycle objects. There's also a new functionality implemented with 1872 or 8047. That is mom as group or parent. So that means you can get all informations, for example, of for the tool, for example. That means you want to know what is the parent of cavity mill operation, then you get the back information, this is this one and this one. But at the end, all the things are still there, and it's the same TCL, so you can also use those ones for sure, right? Okay, great, so we are at end of our time. Any further questions, remarks, or otherwise I would wish you all a nice weekend, but maybe someone have a question. Okay, great. Sounds like no. Okay, so then wish you a nice weekend, and thanks for joining today again, and looking forward to the next session. Have a nice one. Bye.